What's up, folks? It's your buddy Fatal Roddy. Tonight we're going to be doing the Raw recap. We started off with Kurt Angle coming out. He hypes up the Ronda Rousey and Nia Jax match at Money in the Bank. Then Stephanie McMahon comes out. She talks about Kurt Angle's performance and says that she will be presiding at the contract signing for Nia Jax and Ronda Rousey. Stephanie McMahon then brings up Roman Reigns, and then almost immediately Reigns comes out to a sea of boos. Shocker. Roman Reigns tells Stephanie McMahon if she's got something to say, say it to him. Stephanie tells Roman that he better watch his temper, to which Roman Reigns replies that she better watch what she says or he'll rip up the WWE superstars in the back. Stephanie starts to BS Roman Reigns, and Reigns tells her to cut the crap. Then Kevin Owens comes out and says that him winning Money in the Bank will be best for business. After wasting a whole bunch of time here, Stephanie McMahon makes the first match of the night, Roman Reigns versus Kevin Owens. This was an eh match. There's a good bit of action though. Roman Reigns spears Kevin Owens outside the ring. Then Jinder Mahal runs up and attacks Roman Reigns, causing a disqualification. They throw Roman Reigns back into the ring. Then Kevin Owens and Jinder Mahal beat down on Roman Reigns. Seth Rollins comes out for the save, beats Owens and Mahal down. Then when we come back from commercial, we have a tag team match. Yay. Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins versus Jinder Mahal and Kevin Owens. This is a very underwhelming match. This is basically the let's get Roman Reigns over hour. Seth Rollins won with the curb stomp on Kevin Owens. Then after the match, Jinder Mahal attacks Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns on the ramp with a steel chair and continues to beat down Roman Reigns till the commercial. It's announced coming back from commercial that at Money in the Bank, we'll have Roman Reigns versus Jinder Mahal. Yay. Great. Can't wait to see that match. We then have Sami Zayn coming out to waste more time about Bobby Lashley. He introduces Bobby Lashley's sisters, and three women come out. After wasting a bunch of time interviewing Bobby Lashley's sisters, supposedly, Bobby Lashley finally comes out. He runs down his sisters, and then Sami Zayn says that Bobby Lashley is a piece of garbage. Sami Zayn and Bobby Lashley's sisters beat down Bobby Lashley, but Lashley was able to power out and beats his sisters up. Sami Zayn runs up the ramp. This was another really big waste of time, as if we didn't see that coming before. We then have Ember Moon versus Alexa Bliss. Before the match, Alexa Bliss gives an interview, something about Visigoths and the Romans. What? I really don't know what the hell she was going for there. But anyways, we finally have a pretty decent match. There's a good bit of back and forth here. Mickey James tried to interfere, but the referee ejected her, which allowed Ember Moon to get the eclipse on Alexa Bliss for the win. And it all goes downhill from here. We have No Way Jose versus Baron Corbin. Again. Really wasn't much of a match. Baron Corbin won with a deep six and end of days. We just keep running these things down to the ground, folks. We then have the B-Team versus Breezango. The B-Team won this one, so they're still undefeated. I think they're going to play this one out, put the titles on them, and they're going to get totally decimated by the Authors of Pain. Just a prediction there. We then have Stephanie McMahon coming out for the contract signing. She talks up the match and then introduces Ronda Rousey and Nia Jax. They both get into the ring, they sit down, and Stephanie McMahon starts stirring the shit between the two of them. Nia Jax and Ronda Rousey sign their contract, then Ronda Rousey tells Nia Jax that she's going to take her title and her arm. And that's it. I really thought something else was going to happen here, but just like most of the night, we've been disappointed so far. As we continue to go further down this rabbit hole, we have Chad Gable versus Dolph Ziggler. Dolph Ziggler won with the super kick. Really wasn't much of a match. Then we have a fatal four-way qualifying match for Money in the Bank for the women. Liv Morgan, Natalya, Sarah Logan, and Dana Brooke. This is an M match. I think we probably could have split these up instead of throwing all the women all in one match like we've been doing, I don't know, the past 10,897 times. Natalya won with a sharpshooter on Liv Morgan, so Natalya moves on to the Money in the Bank ladder match. We then have Elias versus Bobby Roode.
What the fuck?
Again? Elias won with the drift away. As he's walking up the ramp and getting ready to go backstage, Braun Strowman's music hits. He comes barreling out from backstage and runs over Elias. That's probably the best thing that happened so far all night. So Braun Strowman versus Finn Balor. Finally, we have a good match after the slog of a night we've had so far. There was a good bit of back and forth, a good bit of action. Finn Balor had a really good showing. It looked like he was about to take this one, but Braun Strowman got him with the power slam for the win. So what can I say about tonight's Raw? Holy shit, it sucked. It drug on so long, so bad. It was unbelievable. The only really good match that happened tonight was the Braun Strowman-Finn Balor match. Everything else flat out sucked. The first hour was basically nothing but let's get Roman Reigns over. We started the second hour with Sami Zayn just wasting a bunch of fucking time. And just the rest of it just drug on and it was like, just get it over with. Thankfully, we ended with a good match. But that'll do it for this episode of Raw Recap. I'll be back tomorrow for the SmackDown review. Leave a comment down below what you thought of tonight's Raw, what you thought of this video. If you liked it, Please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to share and subscribe. I've been Fatal Roadie. You've been awesome. Thank you very much for watching. And remember, if it's too loud, you're too old. See ya.